before we will see the concept of what is meant by ampere circuit law, and we will see the what will be the Maxwell's third equation, that will be the point form or the differential form, right? Now let's see the another important important concept, that will be the applications for the ampere circuit law. Okay, you already know ampere circuit law, we must have to be applied by means of the symmetrical. Okay, there must be an symmetrical conditions must be present. We have to find out the electric field strength, right? Okay, this applications has to be divided into the three parts. First to be the infinite line charge, and similarly next to be the infinitely coaxial transmission line, and next to be the infinite sheet charge. Okay, now let's see the first concept, that will be the infinite line charge. So I will be taking an infinitely long conductor like this. Okay, I will be placed this B in the z axis. Okay, now what I will be taking means, I will be taking this B my y axis, and similarly this B my x axis. Okay, so this be my origin. Now what I have to do means, I have to be considered some point P. Okay, I will be considered this be my some conductor like this. Okay, assume from this conductor I will be taken this be my point P. From point P to this conductor, how much the electric field strength be present, we have to be find out, that's be our target. Okay, so from this point P to this conductor, I will be taking my distance, or the, that's be the rho. Okay, the distance, that be the rho. So in order to find from point P to this infinitely line charge, you must have to be draw an Amperian path. You must have to draw an Amperian path from point P like this, like in a symmetrical, in an symmetrical like this. Okay, then symmetrical like this. After drawing an Amperian path, this is said to be the Amperian path. This is said to be the Amperian path. After drawing the Amperian path, what you have to do means, you have to be draw a tangent of that circle. Okay, you have to be draw a tangent, and you have to be taken in small length. You have to be check whether circle differential magnetic strength, and as well as, you know, your differential length be the same here or not. Okay, that's the parallel or the perpendicular, you have to be check. So what you have to do means, you have to be draw a tangent like this. Must have to be draw a tangent like this. So must have to be draw a tangent like this. Okay, and here you can see this be my differential length, this be my small differential length dl bar, and here this be my electric field intensity, that be the dh bar or h bar, that's your choice. Here you can see, here my dl bar and as well as in dh bar both be in the same direction, right? That means both arrow will be in the parallel, that is the same direction. So this be like this, like this. If dh bar be like this, my dl bar be like this. And similarly, if you want to observe it clearly, very clearly, that means here you can see, here also I will be, this be the some tangent means some dh bar or the h bar. Okay, so here I will be considered this be my dl bar. Okay, small length dl bar. Here also you can observe my length and the magnetic field intensity, that's be the both be the same, right? Same direction. That means whenever you have to be do the dot product for the same direction, that will be the parallel, means you have to be taken our theta be the 0 degrees. Similarly, if you take your perpendicular, means our theta be the 90 degrees. From ampere circuit law, what will happen, from ampere's circuit law, so here you can see, so this be the integration of h bar dot dl bar, that be equal to I enclosed. H bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. Here you can see, so this be the H bar of dl bar whenever you have to be applied your cos theta. So you must have to be taken the theta be the 0 degrees. Why I will be taking the theta be the 0 degrees? Means here you can see this arrow and similarly this arrow both be the parallel. So both the parallel means I have to be taken the theta be the 0 degrees. So here H bar of integration of dl bar. So this be the I enclosed. So cos 0 degrees, that's be the 1. Okay, that's why. So here this will be the H bar of, so here this be the circumference of the circle. Circumference of the circle. How much is the circumference of the circle? That be the 2 pi rho. So here my rho represents the distance. Okay, 2 pi rho, that will be equal to I enclosed. That will be equal to I enclosed. What will happen to our magnetic field intensity? That be the I enclosed divided by 2 pi rho. I enclosed divided by 2 pi rho. So here you can observe. So magnetic field intensity, that will be the inversely proportional to 1 divided by rho. Right? So here you can see 1 divided by rho. My rho be in the downside. Right? That means whenever in this infinitely line charge, you have to be increased your magnetic field strength, there automatically the distance will become reduced. Okay, if you want to increase the magnetic field strength, the distance will get reduced. If you want to decrease the magnetic field strength, the distance will get increased. Okay, that's the analysis for the infinitely line charge. Similarly, if you want to take the what will happen to the current across the some conductor, okay, which due to the conductor. So this be the capital H due to the conductor carrying current capital I. So here for this case, what you have to do means we have to be taken in some cylinder. Okay, for that electric field lines be there. Okay, here you can see this be my cylinder. Will be taken another pen. Okay, here what I will be doing means I will be taken some current like this. Current I be flowing like this. Okay, here this be the for example, I will be taking this be the origin, this be the midpoint. From midpoint to here this surface, I will be taken my distance be the rho. Okay, I will be taken my distance be the rho. So here what you have to do means, and similarly, so if you want to take this be your point B, okay, from here to here I will be taken my distance be the R. So whenever you have to be taken the distance be the R, here you can clearly observe this be the small r, this be the small r less than or equal to small r, that be the greater than or equal to rho, right? Small r, that be the greater than or equal to rho. Why? Because my r be the big compared to the rho. Why? Because if you want to see the comparison of the line, my r be the big compared to the rho, right? So here at this case, what you have to do means we have to be draw an Amperian path from this point P. You must have to draw an Amperian path like this, a symmetrical Amperian path. So after drawing the symmetrical Amperian path, here also the same condition, you must have to be draw a tangent. Okay, you must have to be draw a tangent this be the some dh bar, and here you have to be taken the small length, that's be the dl bar. Similarly, you have to be check like this. Okay, this be the dl bar and this be the dh bar. Okay, here also you can see my dl bar and as well as n. Here you can see dl bar and as well as dh bar, that's be in the same direction, right? That means you have to be taken your theta be the 0 degrees. So here, if you want to take this be the, by applying the Ampere's law, so this be the integration of L h bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. Okay, so here this be the h bar of, so here this be the undivided by 2 pi, sorry, so h bar of, so integration of dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. So here h bar of, what will be the circumference of the circle, that's be the 2 pi r, that will be equal to I enclosed. So h bar, that will be equal to I enclosed divided by 2 pi r. Okay, that will be equal to h bar, that will be equal to I enclosed divided by 2 pi r. Here you can see, next case, if you want to take, now what I have to do means, now what I have to do means, here you can see, so here this be my electric field lines, sorry, this be my current I. Now before, what you have to do means, you have to be taken your r, that's be the somewhat more than the rho, right? That means your rho be present here, your r be present here. That means r be the obviously big compared to the rho. Now what we have to do means, in this case we have to be take the same, we have to be take the same, that be the r is equal to rho. What will happen if you want to take r is equal to rho, that means similar, my r distance and as well as the rho distance both be the same. What will happen? And similarly, this be my, now this be my point P. Okay, and here my distance, that be the r. If you want to find out, here you can see my rho and this r both be the same, right? Distance be the same, that's why I will be taken r is equal to rho. Now you have to be draw an Amperian path like this inside. If you want to draw an Amperian path like this, right? And here also you can same thing, you have to be draw an tangent, and check for some small length, okay, whether it may be both be the same or not. If you both be the same means, you have to be applied your theta be the 0 degrees. If that be the perpendicular means, you have to be applied your dot product, theta be the 90 degrees. Here also by Ampere's law, so integration of L h bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. So here h bar of integration of dl bar cos 0 degrees, that be equal to I enclosed, cos 0, that be the 1. So here h bar of, so here this be the integration of dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. So this be the circumference of the circle. So here h bar of 2 pi r, that will be equal to I enclosed. So how much you will get? H bar is equal to I enclosed, that be divided by 2 pi r. R h bar, that will be equal to I enclosed divided by 2 pi rho. Why I will be taken? One be the 2 pi r and second be the 2 pi rho. Why? Because means both be the equal, right? in place of R, you have to be substituted with the row. If you have your row, you have to be substituted with the R. Okay, that's you have the flexibility. And here also, if you want to take the circumference of the circle, you have to be substituted the 2 pi rho, or you have to be substituted the 2 pi r. That is the chance or the flexibility be present in this r is equal to rho condition. Why? Because means both will be the same. Okay, but in the before condition, you have to be see cap a smaller that will be absolutely greater than my rho. That's why I will be taken my circumference of circle that be the 2 pi r. But in this case, both be the same. That's your choice. Whatever the condition, you have to be taken. Okay. Next, what you have to do means we have to be taken smaller less than or equal to smaller less than or equal to rho. Okay. Now, here you can see here both be the same, right? But my smaller that be the somewhat somewhat low, okay, somewhat less than compared to this row. Okay, so for example, if I will be consider like this here, here my point P, what I have to do, we have to be doing an Amperian path like this. Okay, here also you can see same dl bar and as well as in dh bar, right? Similarly, you have to be applied your Ampere's law. What will happen? So here you can see this r be the small, right, compared to this radius that be the rho. Okay, so in order to find that, you have to be if you apply the Ampere's law, what will happen? By Ampere's law, integration of h bar dot dl bar that will be equal to I enclosed. H bar dot dl bar that will be equal to I enclosed. But if you want to find out the I enclosed here, how you can find? Here you can see, here you can, if you want to find out the I enclosed, current enclosed, you have to be made it by means of the two areas, that be the desired area divided by total area. So here I enclosed that be equal to desired area divided by total area, desired area divided by total area into I. So here your desired area that be the pi r square divided by your total area that be the pi rho square into I. Okay, so if you want to know all the things are the common only. Okay, so here integration of h bar dot dl bar, so cos 0 degrees that be equal to I enclosed. So here h bar of dl bar that will be equal to pi r square divided by pi rho square into I. So h bar of, so how much, that's be the circumference of the circle, that's be the 2 pi r that be equal to pi r square divided by pi rho square into I. So here you can see r one time cancel, pi will get cancelled. So h bar that will be equal to r square divided by 2 pi rho square into I. R square divided I into, so this is R, right? I into R divided by 2 pi rho square. Okay, that's be for the infinite line charge. Now what we have to do is we have to be find out by means of the infinitely coaxial transmission line. Okay, next case, that be the infinitely coaxial transmission line. Here I will be consider the two conductors, circular conductors. So I will be taken this be my one conductor, and similarly this be my another conductor. Okay, it has some thickness. It has some thickness T. It has some thickness T. Okay, so for example, if I will be taking the current here, I will be taking the current IB with the inside the water. Okay, so here, from here, this be the origin, right? From here to this inner conductor, I will be taking this be the A. From this point to my outer conductor, I will be taking this be the B. Okay, and here, if you want to consider current here, so this be the outside minus I. Okay, I will be consider that current that be the minus I. Okay, here I will be consider this thickness be the T. This thickness be the T. So what will happen if you want to apply the Ampere's law? Okay, if you want to apply the Ampere's law, what will happen? So if you want to take this be the case one. This be the case one. So this be the rho less than or equal to A. Okay. If I will be taken, this be the some point. This be the some point. For example, I will be consider. Okay. This be I will be consider some point. Okay. So for this, you have to be drawn. This be the some point P. Okay. The distance be the rho. The distance be the you have to be said this be the rho. Okay. So I have to be drawn. Amperian path like this. This is said to be the Amperian path. Amperian path. So whenever you have to be applied the Amperian path, clearly you can observe my rho must be the less than or equal to A, right? So my rho must be the less than or equal to A. Here, how you can find out? Here also you can apply it over Ampere's law. So this be the integration of h bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. So here this be the h bar of, so here also you can apply it over tangents. What will happen? So h bar of two pi rho, that will be equal to I enclosed. And what will be our I enclosed? I enclosed, that will be equal to desired area divided by total area into I. So here this be the your desired area, that be the pi a square divided by our total area, that be the pi rho square. Okay. No. So your desired area, that's be the this, right? This Ampere's path. This Ampere's path, your desired area. So that will become your pi rho square divided by the total area. Total area be the inner conductor, that's be the A, right? That's be the pi A square into total current I. So what will happen? Here you can see, here this be the h bar of 2 pi rho, right? This be the circumference of the circle. Here you can see pi will get cancelled. This be the one time. So h bar, that be equal to rho divided by 2 pi a square into I. Rho divided by 2 pi a square. So this be the condition for the rho less than or equal to A. Okay. For example, if you take okay. For example, if you take this be your thickness, and here this be your B, and similarly this be your A, right? And this be your minus A, minus I. The current be in the outside. So here, if you want to take rho in between A to B, so rho in between A to B. In this case, what you have to be take? You have to be take rho in between A to B. How you can take rho in between A to B? So rho in between A to B. That means you have to be taken your Amperian path here in between A to B. This be my point P. You have to be taken your Amperian path like this. Okay, this be your Amperian path. This be your Amperian path. Okay, so that's be in the range of A to B, right? So what will happen if you want to apply the your Ampere's law? So integration of h bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. So this be the h bar of 2 pi rho, that be equal to I. So h bar, that will be equal to I divided by 2 pi rho. So here one thing you have to be observed carefully. So here this be the h bar is inversely proportional to 1 divided by rho. That means if you want to increase the h bar, the rho will get decreased. If you want to decrease your h bar magnetic field strength, your rho bar will get increased. Okay, that's the analysis for this, the rho in between A to B. So for example, if you want to take the another conductor, that's be the C, what will happen? Okay, if you want to take the C also, what will happen? If you want to take the C, so for example, I will consider this be my C. I will be considered this be my C. Okay, here I will be there. I will be considered this be my C and this be my B, and similarly this be my A. Okay, so if you want to take rho in between B to C, if you want to take rho in between B to C, so what will happen? And similarly here also B to C, right? B to C, where you can draw your Amperian path. This be your B, this be your C. So here in between you can draw, right? For example, if you point P, if you consider this be your Amperian path. So this be your Amperian path. This be your Amperian path. Okay. And here if you want to apply your Ampere's law, that will be the integration of L h bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. So here I enclosed, that will be equal to, here you can observe clearly. Okay. If you want to consider the another conductor C, okay, here you can see. I will be here. You can see this. No, right? This be the I minus I of. That's be the desired area divided by total area. So that's be the pi rho square minus pi b square divided by pi c square minus pi b square. Okay. So if you want to take so I minus I, so pi pi is will get cancelled. Okay, this will become the rho square minus b square divided by c square minus b square. So if you want to take I common, that's be the 1 minus rho square minus b square divided by c square minus b square. So this be your I enclosed. So this will become the I of c square minus b square minus rho square plus b square divided by c square minus b square. Here minus b square plus b square will get cancelled to each other. So this will become the I of c square minus rho square divided by c square minus b square. So this be your I enclosed. This be your I enclosed. Okay. So substitute in this formula. So this will become the h bar of this be the dl bar, that will be equal to I of c square minus rho square divided by c square minus b square. So this be the h bar of 2 pi r, that be equal to I of c square minus rho square divided by c square minus b square. So h bar, that be equal to I divided by 2 pi r of c square minus rho square divided by c square minus b square. Okay. So if you want to draw in a plot for this, okay, if you want to draw in plot for this, so okay, here you can see rho is equal to A, and here is you can see rho is equal to B and rho is equal to C. Okay, so this be the I divided by 2 pi A, I divided by 2 pi A, and similarly this be your I divided by 2 pi B. So this be the exponential increasing. So whenever it will be C, the I is equal to B, it will be somewhat exponentially decreasing like this. Afterwards it will be the exponentially decreasing. Okay. Next, we will see the infinite sheet current. Infinite sheet current. So what will happen if you want to take the infinite sheet current? Actually, this concept will be the so simple concept only. Don't worry about that. In 5 minutes we can complete our session. So here I will be taken this be my z axis, and similarly this be my y axis, and similarly this be my x axis. Okay, for this what I will be taken means I will be taken one infinite sheet. Okay, infinite sheet like this. If I will be considered one infinite sheet like this. Okay, if you want to find out your electric field lines, be like this. Your electric field lines I be like this. Okay, so that's be in the direction of y direction, right? That's be in the direction of ky into ay bar. So that's be in the direction of y direction, unit vector be the ay bar. So if you want to take infinite sheet, what you have to do means if you want to take above, the electric field lines will be passing, there will be no magnetic strength, right? Below, if you want to take, means there will be no magnetic field strength. So at this case, what we have to do means we have to be cut that rectangular sheet. Okay, we have to be cut the small part of the rectangular sheet like this. If you want to just cut your small rectangular part like this, okay, for which you can see there will be a lot of electric field lines you can observe right here. And whenever the electric field will be there, there must be the magnetic field strength also be there. Okay, here we can find out that magnetic field strength, okay, by using this infinite current sheet. Here I will be name it as an, but this is small part, but cutting small part I will be name it as an, now 1 2 3 4 like this. Okay, so you have to be taking your direction as your wish. Next, what the thing you have to be do means, now whenever you have to be take the direction, you have to be applied by means of the Ampere's law, right? So here if you want to apply your Ampere's law, and here I will be taken, this be my for example, this length be my A, B, and for example I will be considered this be my height be the A. Okay, next, by Ampere's law, okay, what will happen? Ampere's law, integration of h bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed, h bar dot dl bar, that will be equal to I enclosed. Here you can observe clearly, here if you want to do the integration, there will be a lot of parts be present, right? Here 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2, 4, 4, 2, 1. You have to do that much of integrations. That means here this be the first, you have to do 1, 2, 2 plus 2 to 3 plus 3 to 4 plus 4 to 1. Okay, this be the DL bar. So that be equal to some I enclosed. Okay, and here how much the current I will be enclosed in which direction? That's be the ky into ay bar. Okay, ky into ay bar. Okay, here how you can write this be the ky into my y bar. So y direction how much be present? B be present. So ky into b, ky into b. Now here you can see what I will be do means I will be do it in different type of diagrams. Clear it care, see it carefully. So 1, 2, 3 and as well as in 4. Okay, done. Here you can see my directions I will be taken. I will be taken my directions. So here you can observe, if you want to take here, there will be no problem. Here there will be all the directions be same. Here there will be no problem. All the directions be same, right? Here also there will be no problem. All the directions be same. But all the directions be same. But whenever our problem will get means, if you want to integrate these two things, if you want to integrate these two things, here you can see, here this be the upper area, right? This be the upper area and this be the lower area. If you want to integrate the upper area minus lower area, how much you will get? You will get your answer be the zero if you do the integration, right? That means here you can see, here we can't get any problem. Okay, here we can't any get any problem, but whenever we have to be do here, okay, if you want to take another rectangle like this, okay, there you can see first rectangle be like this area, my second rectangle area be like this. At that case my area will become the zero. Area means integration. If you want to do the integration, for that integration that will become the zero. So here you can observe this arrow be present in the z axis, right? This arrow be present in the z axis. There you can see our, that means our z axis will become the zero. There will be a no problem for then x axis and as well as in y axis, right? Here also you can see this be the same. Positive area and in negative area will get cancelled to each other. You will get answer with a zero. And similarly here also, right? Done. Now you can see, if you want to take, we'll make some final results here. Here if you want to see 1 2 2 1 2 2, there will be a no. 1 2 2, this be the 1 2 3 4, right? Means here also some be present, some rectangle be present, and this and that will be get cancelled to each other. How much you will get? You will get an answer be the zero. Okay, you will get your answer be the zero. So 0 into dx plus, if you want to take from 2 to 3, if you have any problem, no, right? All be in the same direction. All be in the same direction. But you can observe one thing. From 2 to 3, my direction of arrow be this side, but my x-axis be this side. Okay? My arrow be like this, but my x-axis be like this. But how you can see? This will become the minus hx into minus dx. How I can write this minus symbol, you already know, right? Why I can write? Here if you consider my 2 to 3, my 2 to 3 be in the opposite to my x-axis. Opposite to my x-axis. My x-axis be like this. My 2 to 3 be like this. Both are will be opposite. That's why that opposite represents the minus symbol. Okay, plus next 3 to 4. 3 to 4, 0, right? 3 to 4, 0. Both are will get cancelled. 0 into dx. Plus if you want to take 4 to 1, there will be no issue at all. There will be no issue at all. Why? Because that's be in the z direction, x direction only. This arrow and this arrow both be in the same direction. This be the hx into dx. That will be equal to I encircle. I encircle, how much we will get? That be the ky into b. That's be the ky into b. So how you can solve this? So if you want to solve this, this will become the hx dx plus hx dx, that will be equal to ky into b. So here hx so if you want to take your differential length, small differential length, that will become your b plus hx into b, that will be equal to ky into b. So why I will be taking the b means my 2 to 3 b, that's b. The if you want to take the small length, that's b in the, that's be the b, right? That's why I will be taking here. If you want to take your b common, that's be the hx plus hx, that will be equal to ky into b. BB will get cancelled. So 2hx, that will be equal to ky, that will be equal to hx, that will be equal to ky divided by 2 for z greater than 0, and similarly minus ky divided by 2 for minus z less than 0. Okay, these two results be the very very important. Okay, I hope you understand this concept. Simply don't worry, I will be explaining to you one more time in a clear way. First thing, what way I will do means infinite sheet current, right? I will be taking the sheet. If I will be taking this be the sheet, if you want to apply the current in the above axis, there will be no electric field, there will be no electric field means there will be no magnetic field strength. Suppose I will be taking the below, I will be applied my current like this. If I will be, there will be no current means there will be no magnetic field, obviously. But my sheet be like this. Here there will be no current. That's why I will be cut this piece. Okay, this rectangular piece I will be just cutting. A cut part, whenever I will be put it here, okay, at that time some electric field lines be present. Whenever the electric field lines be present, magnetic field be present. So I will be put lines like this. Okay, so here you can see I will be named as 1 2 3 4. Okay, what you have to do by using the Ampere's law, you must have to be find out the integration. Integration means area, right? You have to be find out this, all of those conditions 1 2 2 2 3 2 3 2 4 4 2 1. But you can clearly observe, whenever you have to be do the integration for the positive area and the negative area, both will get cancelled to each other, you will get your answer be the 0. That means here my z axis will become the 0 here in this case, this slot 3 to 4 and as well as 1 2 4. But there will be no problem from 1 to 4 as well as in 2 to 3. Why? Because there will be no mismatching be happen, right? Whenever you have to be taken from 2 to 3, my, if you want to take the x-axis in this direction, my, you can observe the arrow be in the direction, that will be the opposite. That's why I will be taking the minus. Okay, minus here dx bar, what, how much the distance? The distance be the b. Okay, and similarly here you can see this be further, this arrow and this arrow be in the same direction. So I will be taking this be the hx into dx. Okay, if you want to take the b common, you will be just cancel to each other. How much you will get? Hx is equal to ky divided by 2 for the greater than 0, and if you want to take the for the less than 0, that will become the minus ky divided by 2. Okay, this was the simple analysis for the applications of the Gauss law. Okay, in the next class we will try to see what will be the magnetic flux density and what will be the magnetic scalar and what will be the magnetic vector and as well as its potentials. Okay, I hope you like this video. If you really like this video, please like my video, share my video, as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.